Je vais vous parler aujourd'hui de la cohérence des politiques publiques.
Today, I would like to tell you about the consistency of public policies and to demonstrate why it is a prerequisite for the attainment of sustainable development goals. Reaching these goals almost exclusively relies on public policies to manage antagonisms and synergies. In order to pursue public policies, governments have a number of tools available, short-term instruments and long-term instruments. Short-term actions are known in economic terms as cyclical policies aiming to influence growth, employment, price stabilities, and external balance. Several types of policies are available for governments to use. First, fiscal policy. For example, if a government wants to implement a recovery policy, it may increase public spending, thus contributing to an increase in demand for companies, which in theory helps create jobs and increase economic activity. Second, there are also tax policies, which consist in acting on taxes, especially those bearing on households. When households pay less taxes, it increases their purchasing power and their capacity to consume more, which boosts demand and increases economic activity for companies. There is also monetary policy, which acts on interest rates and the volume of credit available to fuel the economy, providing access to credit and loans for households and increasing demand. And other kinds of policies exist, such as regulatory policies, for instance, a decision which institutes a minimum wage or increases the existing minimum wage. Some policies are aimed at structuring economies on the medium and long term. They are called structural policies. They have an impact on the economy's potential for growth, on sectorial distribution, on sectorial specializations, for instance, agriculture, industry or trade, and services, and they also act on social cohesion. Governments may choose to reduce disparities, to pursue an interventionist social policy. It is a matter of making an economic policy choice. One example of industrial policy in developing countries in recent history, starting in the 60s, a number of countries embarked on the creation of export processing zones. These zones are mostly based on the textile industry, and one could mention Mauritius or Tunisia, two examples of countries benefiting from favorable tax duties, favorable to imports of raw materials and tax incentives as well. The purpose is to implement a strong-willed policy to promote exports. In the field of agriculture, governments have a number of levers available, such as subsidizing some food products in order to guarantee a minimum income for farmers. Conversely, the government may choose to lower prices so that food products destined to be exported remain competitive or are competitive on international markets. These policies may be accompanied by policies in the field of training and education, innovation, research, and increasingly environmental issues. I'd like to use the example of the magic square of Nicolas Cador. This post-Keynesian economist was an advisor for many South and Northern Hemisphere governments in the 60s and 70s. It shows that we have four goals in terms of economic policies which are difficult to reconcile: growth, employment, price stability, and external balances, among which the trade balance, which is not the only one. Let us take the example of the impact a recovery policy could have, regardless of whether it comes from increased public spending, fiscal policy, a tax policy, lower taxes, a regulatory policy, higher minimum wage. It will fuel growth and will create jobs. We could refer to SDG number 8, aimed at promoting growth, employment, and decent working conditions. However, Cador derived from series of statistics over long periods of time in developed and developing countries, the observation according to which this growth and possible decrease in unemployment rate are usually associated with inflation, which burdens the purchasing power of households and is also detrimental for competitiveness, considering that inflation raises the price of exported goods versus those of imported goods. Here, with regard to external balances, we have SDG number 17, referring to international partnerships, trade between countries, and more widely, relationships between public and private players, etc. What Kaldor had seemingly disregarded was the existence of disparities which play a greater and greater role in the international agenda, especially the SDG agenda. For instance, SDG number 10 on reduction and eradication of poverty, we also have SDG 1. The connection between growth and inequalities and the reduction of inequalities is not automatic. Oftentimes, inequality reduction must be achieved through a strong-willed policy. It is first and foremost a matter of public policy. In the 60s and 70s, the environment was a less pressing matter. However, nowadays, we cannot but combine growth with environment protection policies, factoring in the climate change. We're referring to SDG 11 to 15 on sustainable consumption and production, sustainable towns, marine ecosystems preservation, and fight against climate changes. In fine, public policies are a matter of choice, and the issue of consistency between public policies is an important one. It all depends on the government's capacity to elaborate medium and long-term strategies and choose between policies or political instruments that may have positive cumulative effects, but also contradictory effects as well as negative cumulative effects. Once the policies are in place, someone needs to drive public action, and it all relies on the quality of public institutions. As early as in the 60s, economists saw the institutional economy current emerge, and even those who belonged to the dominating current understood the relevance of taking into account in their analysis the institution level of quality. This matches SDG 16 perfectly: peace, justice, and institutions' efficacy. The take-home message will be: the aim for public policies first consists in managing antagonistic goals, such as the sustainable development growth goals. Governments have tools of fundamental importance available to them. Choosing a public policy often commits the countries for many years, and there is no such thing as a good public policy without high-quality institutions and public will.
Sans institutions de qualité et sans volonté politique.